Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the second video on solid principles. In the previous video, we basically got introduced to the solid principle concept and then quickly went through the very first principle of solid principle, that is SRP, single responsibility principle. We have seen how the code that violates single responsibility principle looks like. Now it is time to continue the journey, and the next principle is OCP, that is open and close principle. What is this principle? Well, the definition says software entities should be open for extension and closed for modification. When I say entities, it basically means classes, modules, and functions. The classes, modules, and functions should be open for extension and closed for modification. Well, what does it mean? Let's bring back the code that we had seen in the previous video and try to analyze the same code using the prism of open and close principle and see how it violates it. Now, look at the class notification service. It has a hard-coded dependency on email service. So the notification service has a direct dependency on what kind of service it uses. Later point in time, if you want to use the notification service without the email service, or instead of using email service, want to use, say, SMS service, you can't use the notification service unless you start modifying the notification service class. That is exactly what the definition says. It should be closed for modification. But here you are ending up with a class where you have to do the modification if you want to reuse it. That should not be the case. You should be able to use it or reuse it without being forced to modify it. So the classes should be open for extension but closed for modification. Let's go through a couple of more examples to really get the idea. Here, it is much more simpler. We are dealing with only one single class. We have a class called payment processor, and we have a function inside that process payment. And then we basically process the payment based on the payment type. The payment type could be credit card or PayPal. And then we have the actual functions, which are process credit card payments and process PayPal payments, which are being used inside the process payment. Initially, code looks fine. Process payment is handling all different types of payments, but there is a problem. As of now, the payment processor is handling credit card payment and PayPal payment. But let's assume that later you introduce mobile wallet payment. You have to come and add another new case under when to be able to do the mobile wallet payment. Later sometime, one more payment might get introduced. Let's say UPI payment. Then once again, you will have to come here in this payment processor class and start fiddling with the existing code. Basically, the function process payment is slowly growing. That basically means, once again, the payment processor is open for modification. That is, you can come and modify it here, but closed for extension. I can't reuse this payment processor without modifying the process payment implementation. So once again, this is open for modification, but closed for extension, which is total opposite of what OCP says. That is, it should be open for extension, but closed for modification. Let's take another example. You have a class called FileReader, and that FileReader is capable of handling two types of files, that is text file and CSV file. Let's assume that we now want to introduce one more kind of format to be read, say read PDF file. That means once again, we will have to add one more long complicated code for reading a PDF file in the same single class and function. That means once again, this is open for modification instead of extension. Exactly what OCP doesn't recommend. I hope you are already getting the idea of what it means to have a code which is open for modification and closed for extension and why it is problematic code. Let's take a real life example. Let's assume that you are building a house and you have a construction worker and he is constructing a house. And when you are constructing a house, you can construct a wooden house or you can basically ask the constructor to build a masonry house. But what if later you ask the same person to do a plumbing job as well? Is he skilled enough to do that particular job? And what if later you ask the same person to do wiring work as well? So what's happening here is you are trying to get all the work done from the same entity. Specialized entities are not present to deal with different kind of scenarios, and skill-based delegation is not done. And open and close principle tries to address this exact problem. If you follow an open and close principle, you should be able to have separate set of specialized classes to deal with different kind of scenarios. So let's try to see where this kind of problem exists in a real project code. I want to take you back to the same old code base where we have implemented an application that basically shows list of countries that you can scroll through. And one of the class that we have implemented here is Country Repository. We have implemented this application as a part of the previous room database series. Now, let's have a look at the Country Repository. This Country Repository has four functions, that is fetch and insert all, get all countries, delete country, and update country. Seems fine. But later point in time, let's assume that you want to add filter functionality, search functionality, split functionality. You will end up adding all of those functionalities in the country repository itself with this approach. Of course, you can solve it, but we are not looking at how to solve it as of now. What we are basically observing is in its current approach, this country repository doesn't provide you an option to do more than these things without actually modifying the class itself. And that's exactly what we don't want. We should be able to reuse and extend the repository's functionality without having to modify the country repository. That should be our approach. And that is why this particular code is problematic code and it violates the open and close principle. In the next video, we will move on to the next concept, which is LSP. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.